Hey guys, welcome to La Cave in 5. At La Cave in 5, I'm trying to explain everything in roughly around 5 minutes. So let's jump right in. Our topic for today is recursive selection in GrandMA3. So what does it mean and how can we work with that? Good, basically, let's jump into the GrandMA3 on PC software and have a look at the patch. At the patch in GrandMA3, everything is kindly arranged in a tree structure. So for example, if I have a look here at this item, this is a grouping item, and there I have patched 4 impression x4 bars 20. The grouping fixture has a fixture ID 800, and then the bars themselves, so the fixtures themselves, are called 801, 802, 803, and 804 in this example. Good. So now I'm going to select them like we are used to. So we type in 801, press highlight, and there it is. Now we can go to the next by pressing the next button. This is the next item. Next and next and so on. Now, the first cool thing is that on GrandMA2 we would like to step into the next instance, and here on GrandMA3 we are basically on the same layer. So we stay here in this fixture basement, for example. It's not the basement themselves because we have everything aligned in the tree structure, but yes, to keep it simple at the moment, I call it the basement. Good. Now, I show you the magic of it. Let's type in 801 plus 802. Now we have selected the first two bars, of course. This is nothing special. But now I can select 801, press the dot, and yet, for example, I press 1. Now I have selected the first child item in the tree structure of the fixture 801. So as you all know from GrandMA2, you think it's the instance, but it isn't really instance because it's the in the tree structure 1 point down. And then we have the next item. When I step through now with the next, you can see the light is now going on. And when I come to the last fixture, 20 in that case, I can't go to the next one because I stay in the whole fixture 801. Another example, 801.1 plus 2. That means that I'm selecting fixture 801. And then the child 1 and 2. In that case, these are the instances 1 and 2, so the first two LEDs. If I would like to select the first 5 LEDs, I can say 801.1 through 5, for example. Now I can go through the first 5. And now I want to select the first 5 LEDs of fixture 801 and fixture 802. So I press 801 plus 802. Point, decimal, and then 1 through 5. Now I have here the first 5 LEDs, and then I jump to the next fixture, 802, and the next 5 LEDs. So this is a really, really cool feature and a really game changer because it makes it very, very flexible and very, very fast. Of course, if I want to select fixture 801 through 804 and all LEDs in a row, I can simply type in 801 through 804, sorry, point through. And now I have select all my basic childs of fixture 801 through 804. If I can step through, you can see it here. So this is a really, really handy tool. For example, I can make different selections. What about when I press 800? 800 was basically my group fixture. So these are the group fixture. This is the group fixture where it contains all the X4 bars. And in this example, I wanna select the third and the fourth bar of my group fixture 800. So I can press 800. Point 3 plus 4. In this case, I've used the tree structure to select the fixtures. So imagine you have got several trusses and you want to select maybe only the first three fixtures of these trusses. Then you type in the name of the truss, the point, and then which kind of item. In this case, one through three, for example. This is basically the new selection where we can do a lot of great stuff with it. For example, I have used this selection to make a grid of my X4 bars, how they are arranged in the physical way. So, for example, I'm switching over to my groups and I'm selecting the grid over here. And now, switching back. Here you can see I've used this grid here, and that was created like this. First of all, let's select 801 point through to select all the LEDs of that row. So in this case, that. Now hit the next button until the first overlapping one. Okay, that's that. Now I change to this selection grid over there. Now I press the plus. 802 plus 803 point through to add the next elements. Now let's change back to this camera that we can see better where the next overlapping one is. In this case it's roughly around here. I'll take that one. Now choose this grid position, say plus 804 point through to select all the LEDs. And now I've got my group with the correct alignment of the grid finished. So that's it for all today. Oops. I hope you liked the video. Please click the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. See you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.